Gurudev, could you speak on the Shiva principle from the point of view of classical and quantum physics?
Shiva principle is the summum bonum of whole creation. As you know, through quantum physics, we say everything is vibration. Shiva principle is that general vibration. In vibration, the ancient rishis said two types of vibration. One is the common vibration or the general vibration, and then they said special vibrations. Special vibration are the modified vibration of the general vibration. So, samanya spanda, spanda means waves, vibration. Shiva is called the samanya spanda, the common vibration of the whole existence. And earth, water, fire, ether, any object that you perceive, you can see, they are called special vibrations. So, vishesha spanda. The vishesha spanda is not as important as the common spanda. Chandrayaan, jo gaganyaan gaye the, Chandrayaan ke scientist hai. वहाँ से वैज्ञानिक है तो कुछ प्रश्न पूछ रहे हैं शिव तत्व के बारे में तो मैं बात कर रहा हूँ. सो द स्पेशल वाइब्रेशंस और द ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड द कॉमन वाइब्रेशन और ओरिजिनल वाइब्रेशन जनरल वाइब्रेशन इज व्हाट इज कॉल्ड शिव तत्व. सो विदाउट शिव तत्व देर इज नो अदर तत्व कैन एग्जिस्ट. लाइक विदाउट स्पेस नो ऑब्जेक्ट कैन एग्जिस्ट. दैट इज शिव इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड आकाश Chidakash. Chidakash is the space of consciousness in which everything else exists. So even if you want to be away from Shiva, it is impossible. Because existence itself is Shiva.
Gurudev, physicists have noted that similarity between the probability density field of an electron and the dance of Shiva. What is the connection between the movement of subatomic particles and Shiva's dance?
Yeah, Shiva's, there are 108 dance poses of Shiva. And so, you have said it very nicely. As scientist, you have shown the atomic particle moves like the dance of Shiva. Because nothing is stationary, everything is in movement. And so also Shiva is in principle is in constant movement, and that is why it is consciousness. And Ananda Tandava, there is many Tandavas, one is Ananda Tandava, the waves of bliss. And the waves of bliss gets generated when Shiva Tattva or Shiva principle is imbibed or recognized in the being. Yeah.
Gurudev, could you please speak on dark matter, dark energy and the Shiva principle?
Well, dark matter and dark energy, in the Rig Veda there is a sukta called Nasadiya Sukta. In Nasadiya Sukta it is said, in the beginning, there was darkness enveloped by darkness. These people could not understand what is this. When the German scholar Max Müller came to India, he was the one who first translated Vedas into English. Then he said he could not understand what is the dark matter, the darkness enveloped by darkness. And there was water, and there was movement. These are the. But then, meditation could reveal this. Aurobindo, Rishi Aurobindo, completely saw that from the other side of experience. And today, scientists have really said, have understood what the ancient principle that said, there was grand, in the beginning there was neither existence nor non-existence. Nasadasi, Nosadasi, Tadani. You can't say it existed, you can't say it did not exist. And the darkness was surrounded by darkness. So, actually Shiva principle cannot be understood by our logical minds. It is beyond that. It's an experiential existence.
Gurudev, what is the energy phenomenon that happens especially during Shivaratri?
Shivaratri is actually there are 12 Shivaratris. Every month there is one Shivaratri before the new moon. But this one in the Magha Masa is considered very special. On this day, you sit and meditate, chant Om Namah Shivaya, and that it is beneficial for one's spiritual growth. So, Mahashivaratri meditations are very vibrant, powerful, and you feel deeper connection to the existence. You are anyway connected to the existence. But when you go deeper in meditation, go beyond the ephemeral, then you feel that connection more. And for spiritual evolution, it said, it just removes all the mala, avarna and vikshepa, all the impurities in the mind and the veil on the soul. You know, soul comes with a veil, and Shivaratri is the day when the veil is loosened up. You can peep through the veil, something that is beyond human comprehension. Yeah. So meditating on Shivaratri day, in layman's words, says it removes all the sins. And your desires get fulfilled. So laymen are said, oh, just do meditation Shivaratri day, chant Om Namah Shivaya, and you wish something and it can happen. So our consciousness is also like computer. Whatever wish you put at a particular condition, the wish manifests. And different places, different situation, different time is more congenial for that. See, for example, when you plant trees or there are fruits which are seasonal. Mango grows only in this season, the summer, right? It can be grown in the greenhouse, that is a different thing. Anything can be grown in the greenhouse and at any time with controlled temperature. But normally, there is a season where the trees bear fruit. Like that, some of the festival, Navaratri, Shivaratri, are those time when our prayers are answered, our wishes bear fruits. That's the ancient beliefs, and it is happening for millions of years now. Yeah.
Gurudev, when the Devi was born as Daksha's daughter, she couldn't remain as Shiva's consort. But as the daughter of Himavan, as Parvati, she remains as the consort of Shiva. What was the difference?
See, the Puranas, you cannot just see from one side. All these Puranas have got deeper meanings, many aspects in it, many different ways you can see it. One thing is Shiva and Shakti cannot be separated. If they separate, then there is problem. So that's why they are part of each other. And this apparent distance or difference is only for understanding. Understanding the matter as separate from energy. Matter and energy cannot be separated. But for common understanding, another level, the classical chemistry level, we understand all these are different matters. But in the quantum physics, there is no difference, it doesn't matter. what periodic table you are looking into, it, none of those matter. All that matters is the wave function.